niggas that way, like, a nigga vent about his shit, talking about some real shit, like, motherfuckers ain't gonna like that shit. Niggas ain't gonna, like, niggas want that, you know.
Yeah.
Like, that stuff.
You know I get out there quick, but they said to them, get out my dick.
Yo. What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy Leaky, and I'm back with another video. By the title, y'all already know what this video is. Another interview with Kane. And shit, he told me to let him know when to call. Tell him to go ahead and call now. Yeah. About to get this interview going. I'm gonna set that up. This man about to call soon. Cause we're gonna get straight into it. Cause like a little while ago, he sent me like 10 unreleased tracks, and I got a lot of questions about these songs, especially the first four. I ain't gonna speak on the names until he called me. But these four first songs, the beats, they resemble each other a lot. Good beats. I'm gonna play a little bit right quick before you call me. Fuck this one right here.
Young Suave on the track.
Every time my niggas like, way before the coronavirus, I've been social distancing. Staying in my own lane since I was a kid. And like, I gotta speak from the heart on this. So I mean, like, just understand my lane.
Yo.
What's
up with the gang?
What's up, man?
Good. Good, man.
That nigga playing that guy now. No, you playing that guy. That's so stiff, man. I ain't let nobody at that shit.
Nah, you ain't. Hey, look. I just had flitted a little, you know, a little quick, a little brief. You ain't had say not too much on it, so they ain't, you feel me? They ain't really hear nothing.
Oh, yeah, they
heard
that. They said they ain't had too much. So, what's up, my nigga? What's up?
Yeah, chilling, man. How you?
Shit, staying out of the way.
Nah, we go. Hell cool. Yeah. Shit, man. Let's go ahead and just hop straight into the interview right now, because shit. I remember, I don't know exactly how long, because I was just telling them, just now, that you had sent me like 10 tracks that you ain't have released. Did you release any of them, or are you still unreleased?
I ain't released none of them shit. Nah, you still got some clean. I heard you, Fred. Like,
yeah.
I done released other shit before that, but as far as doing right there, hell nah. Nobody hit them.
Okay, so shit. Yeah. Well, fuck it. They gonna bring me to my second question. Goddamn, when you think you gonna... Is you dropping this as a mixtape, or are you dropping these as singles? Like, what you gonna do with them?
Bro, I'm gonna be real with you. I don't got no particular order for none of them shit. I don't even know if I'm gonna drop them as singles, mixtape, or if I'm just gonna use some songs. Because, like, really, it's been taking me a minute to even decide what I was gonna... You know what I'm saying? Because every song got a story. I'm speaking some real shit in every last one of them.
Yeah.
But some of them shits everybody don't deserve to hear. I'm not okay. So,
I feel it. Yeah. Because, I mean, I just gonna give you my opinion on it. I ain't gonna say the names of the songs, but goddamn, you should remember the first four that you had sent me, and that's something I wanna,
Yeah.
That's why I wanna talk about those four songs in particular, because the beats, they not the same, but they resemble each other. So I want you to like walk me through when you was, you know what I'm saying, just getting those beats and then like making a song. Cause the beats, don't shit is fire.
Man, I'm gonna be real with you, bro. I don't write shit. Every beat that you hear, that was my first time hearing, first time being in the studio, and I recorded them shit right then and there. If I can't get a feeling off the beat when I hear it in the studio, then I'm not gonna make shit to it. I skip it. Like my brother right here, he'll tell you, I done did whole songs. And scratch the whole damn song.
Damn.
A whole nother song. Like, it's really just like that. Like, my brother's the team.
So you don't write at all?
I don't feel like
feel it. I don't make everything in there come out. Like, I literally sit in there, put the headphones on, beat come through. I be like, shit. All right, start. Don't think shit. Don't write nothing. Don't do nothing. Everything off the feeling. That's how real shit is.
Okay.
Everything is literally off the feeling.
And shit, how long you been rapping on for the people who don't know?
Shit, I low-key say since middle school for real, but like as far as like putting music out, shit, I ain't really started doing that till about like 10th grade.
Okay, okay.
Like, cause like shit, hey, you niggas who went to Alex Drive or who's from the city and shit, you know, I ain't meet all my country niggas I got older, but like, if you was from the city, you went to Alex Drive, shit, they'd tell you, y'all been beating on tables with pencils and shit, rapping. Everybody surrounded the down table. Like, I really was. I could say on where my class, my time, I was one person doing that shit. But as far as like making music, shit, that's very for sure. So, cause then that's when I started seeing more people, connect with more people and shit like that. And shit, it ain't take nothing. Just get around a bunch of niggas who are already rapping and rap shit. Niggas tell me
so shit, like, cause I ain't gonna lie. Lately, I ain't been really in tune with a lot of people, but like, have you dropped anything recently?
Oh shit! Yeah, I mean, I ain't gonna say recently. It's really dropping this week though. So.
Oh, so you about to drop?
I got a song with my brother 2-3. My nigga GMF 2-3. I know you know who that is.
Yeah.
My nigga 2-3. Shit! I got some shit with him that we done had in the stash for like. Since 2019, for real, like, it's been that long. Like, I've been holding music. I got shit with Lonnie, I can't even speak on. I got some with, you know what I'm saying? I got some shit with a lot of niggas.
Yeah.
Like, just holding and dropping when it's time to drop. Dude. I want everybody to know this shit real. Ain't none of this shit played. Ain't none of this shit fake.
All right, so.
All this shit.
Well, when like. You said you drop when it's ready. Like, when you know when it's time, like, what give you that feeling like it's time to drop?
Shit. Really? I know I be saying some shit, but if I can't have nobody else feel that shit, what make me happy hearing my niggas saying, like, bro, hey, I can see that shit. That's when I know it's ready. Like, don't get me wrong, every song I played, you know, niggas will be like, your home was on our table, hard, but I got some niggas who will be like, yeah, this shit straight, like, it's all right. But when I play some shit, they be like, God, this motherfucker hard, boy, that shit right there. So, like, fact, like, that's how it is. That's just like, when I know somebody else can relate to it, instead of how I feel, like, and just hear it, close their eyes, and see that shit in their head, bro. That's how I know it, right? But I only ask a certain amount of people, you know what I'm saying? Like,
So.
Everybody got a different ear, but when you got different ears from the different times, it mean more. It mean different because ain't nobody talking to nobody. Everybody just blank mind. So you get good from all of them. They're right. It's the one. You putting this on that bit. So I tell you, like, shit, take come. Like, I ain't even going to say how I'm, as a matter of fact, I'm going to say 3 months tops.
Three
Tape
months.
Drop. The videos starting all that shit like now, like everything finna start popping out now. Motherfuckers can see.
Yeah. Well, shit, speaking of videos, when can we expect a visual? Your first one at least. Like first one you about to drop.
2 weeks. 2 weeks. 2 weeks.
That good, literally I know though.
Like 2? Really was getting the money and shit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Any type of way we can get that shit. Back then, I ain't really, you know, niggas just rapping. Niggas going to the studio for 23 hours. I put that bitch up. Nah, I got money to push that shit very real, so.
Yeah, I feel it.
2 weeks.
So, shit, I mean, give me a little background run. Like, where you from, how it was growing up, you know? Like, what pursue you to start rapping anyway? Yeah, that's another question I wanted to know, too.
Shit, I'm from the West, bro. I'm from right here, South Carolina. Man. I was born in Charleston, though, but I moved down here like I was like 2.
Mm.
So, shit, that's why I made my friend, all my stepdad, all my cousin sitting here. but I'm right off that, off the west, but shout out to Live Everywhere. 526 Dingle Street, that's me. Like, I love that place. Like, no matter how bad shit got, that's how, you know, that's what I love. Growing up, shit been decent. I had my man, daddy. I ain't gonna say a lot, like, a nigga ain't had shit. We struggled, you know what I'm saying? Like, I just stayed in hotels and shit like that, but ain't nothing that ain't no experience for me, so. Yeah. It shit was low-key easy, you know, that life flat, but when it came to music, I'm gonna be real with you. My people music is, like, everybody that I'm around love music. Like, if it's not even from hood, it's to church, it's like, all angles you love music. So, I was gonna be involved with the shit in some type of way, but, like, rapping came from just being around my niggas, like, some niggas rapping. I'm the only one that can't rap. I ended up becoming better than all them niggas. Nigga T, like, fast as hell. Once I got right, it was a rap. Like, niggas know, but shit. It made me start taking that shit serious when I started saying, like, shit, I could vent through this shit.
Yeah.
Motherfuckers could tell a lot through music, you know what I'm saying? So when I start being able to say what I want to say, do that shit. Oh, I've been loving that shit. That shit me now.
Yeah, because I've been saying, like, you've been posting on your IG, like, you just post little snippets, and, you know, and I was like, damn, when bro gonna drop? Well, you know what I'm saying? You keep teasing niggas, man.
Yeah, I'm going here for sure, like. If we, like, we could be sober as fuck, we gonna drop. You put me off, like, my niggas are through. Those niggas are that type of time. They dirt my. Yeah, this couldn't come for real. For real.
Yeah. You hear me? Damn, I don't know if it's any connection ain't good or not. Yo.
Yo.
You hear me?
Hey.
Yeah, that shit been going in and out. This is like a first.
This shit got down. I just say, like, this shit really always been there. Like, I always been thinking of the music shit.
Yeah.
It was always somewhere in my mind for real, but it just took some way to bring that shit out, a way to do that shit.
So
I just got fucking telling you, so. Yeah.
You got, like, any producers or any engineers that you work with just, like, specifically just them, or you work with, like, whoever you catch a vibe with?
Shit, any engineer, like, that I work with, like, Trey, I might have bought a couple of his shit. Trey, I got a 10, of course you got two songs. On the city lot, you just gotta have one. Shit.
Damn.
That was it. There's them three niggas for sure. So.
Shit.
Yeah, I ain't gonna eat, like, shit, shit, hit. Every time I hear him.
You got any artists, local artists, or any artists that you ain't had know, but now you know that y'all got some work coming in the near future?
I ain't know that nigga Lil Rich hard as hell. I know I got some shit coming in the works, you know?
Okay.
My nigga Lil Black, actually my cousin, but you know, I ain't know new rappers till he got around my ass. Like, niggas used to hide the shit, you know, but Lil Black, shit, who else? Lil Black, but, yeah. Shouldn't I say 2-3? But I always do 2-3. But I ain't know 2-3 is 2-3. I knew 2-3 Swish, man. I meant Swish, man. So we got down. When we separated and 2-3 came, but I was like, oh, this is hard. Like, oh, shit. Yeah. Had to link you. Shit. But everybody else already know him. Already had a connection to him and shit. So it was never linking and getting timing. That's it.
So, man. And I see, well, at least from the music that I done heard, and then the one that you done sent me, I see you really be, you know what I'm saying, rapping that pain. And matter of fact, I'm gonna ask you the same question that I asked in my last interview, because I feel like your music give a resemblance to it. Because I don't know if it was yesterday or the day before that, I think on IG or some shit, Quavo was like, they should go ahead and make a new genre called Trap Soul, because everybody's starting to sing their struggles now on the beat. Do you feel like your music just fit in with that?
Shit. Yeah, yeah. That shit, I feel like it fit right in there, because it's like, it's a lot of shit that niggas talk about. And I wouldn't even say afraid. I'd say shit like, the city made us that way, like, a nigga venting about his shit or talking about some real shit, like, motherfuckers ain't gonna like that shit. Niggas ain't gonna like, niggas want that, you know.
Yeah.
Like, that's the fuck that bitch, you feel me? We can't blame him, because that's us, you didn't. But, like, for a nigga to talk about some shit that's non, like, that don't really gotta be street related, you know what I'm saying? Not saying niggas ain't did what they did, because niggas know, but I'm just like, shit, let me tell you about how my mama be feeling on young night. She wake up crying, you know what I'm saying? Let's talk about that. Niggas don't know about that. Let's talk about how your bitch cheating on you, but shit, you still gotta got down, go make money. Shit. Let's talk about that type of shit. You know what I'm saying? But like, ain't saying the niggas soft. It's just shit. Niggas feel like me every day, but niggas ain't gonna say it. I ain't afraid to.
For sure. And shit, and speaking of that, you saying, rapping about, you know what I'm saying, how your mama feeling and shit like that. Like, what made it comfortable for you to be able to just, you know what I'm saying, to spit your feelings out on the beat? Cause I know for some people, you know what I'm saying, some people that shit ain't easy, you know?
Shit, when I got to school, when I started hanging around, you know, shit, my niggas did other shit. I was a nigga that could do capitally and still dab niggas up from the hood.
Yeah.
So niggas still know I'm from, you know what I'm saying? So I never looked to be a part of anything. Like, I always looked like I could fit in with everybody.
Mm-hmm.
But I also looked like I was also out of place every time, because there'd be certain shit motherfuckers would do that I wouldn't do.
Right.
So, shit, when you already put in an uncomfortable spot, it should be nothing else uncomfortable for you to even relate to or talk about, you know what I'm saying? Not to. You already put in the unsettled spot anyway. You just born in the adapt to that shit.
For sure. And shit, goddamn, before we wrap up the interview, man, you got like anything you want to say or any shout outs you want to give out to anybody who might be watching?
They already knew over there. I don't even gotta say, man, the motherfuckers should know, but just know them bitches right here beside me. Stop playing with me. But shit. Shout out to anybody who fucking with me. I ain't gonna, you know what I'm saying? It's all love to everybody, but you know, motherfucker, you have to uncover pressure, so you'll never know. Mm-hmm. Shit, somebody might not like you tomorrow, but shit.
Man, free the real niggas
on top of that, shit. Man, Kane on the way, bro. That's all I really can say. Kane come. Y'all been asking. Y'all been goddamn wondering. Niggas stay in my DM talking that bullshit. Niggas stay making posts about me. I'm on the way, bro. Ain't too much to wait on no more. It's up in the start, just like that.
For sure.
Oh, yeah. Shout out to Gang. FOB shit, nigga. Forever goddamn. Shout out to Gang. Why niggas know that is? Real shit.
So, man, appreciate you taking time out, you know what I'm saying, and had the interview, goddamn.
Oh, shit,
for sure,
nigga. All right, let's talk one nigga leave, man. One nigga stay with me. One nigga stay at the camp. It's always been love me. This nigga been tapped in about 2-3 years now. This shit been supposed to happen. Like, shit, since 2018, this shit been supposed to happen. niggas been taking their time though. But you know, we done made it happen. What's up, man? Y'all finna see more of me for sure. So.
Yeah. Gots to.
Say hi, my nigga. Stay safe, nigga. You know how you do
it. You know it. You too, bro.
You know I get out there quick, but they said to them get out my-